Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to another video. Today's video is going to be a lot different from what I'm used to uploading. Today we're going to be talking about Grand Theft Auto 6's new trailer. Thank you to Rockstar Games for releasing a trailer finally. So in today's video, we're going to be looking at some screenshots I took from the trailer, a bunch of screenshots, and I'm going to be pointing some things out to you guys, and I'm going to be giving you guys my opinion on Grand Theft Auto 6 and what I think about it. Now, some of you guys may be disappointed with my opinion, and some of you guys may agree with it. Whatever it is, leave it in the comment section below. Keep it respectful. You know, we are all here. We all have different opinions about games and what's being released. And personally, this is just mine. Now, I want to make note on something, because this channel has been mainly focusing on FPS games. So, you know, Call of Duty, Battlefield, or whatever it is. Actually, I hardly upload Battlefield, but a lot of Call of Duty, and I mainly focus on first-person shooters and tactical military-style games. But Grand Theft Auto is something that I grew up with. I played it on the PS2. I think my first Grand Theft Auto was GTA 3. And then Vice City, San Andreas. I know San Andreas was the most memorable for me, and that is what I spent the most time playing. And then, of course, Vice City. And then I had the PSP back then, Liberty City Stories, Vice City Stories. So, like, I know the GTA world. I've been around for a while, and I've played every single GTA. And loved, okay, well, not every single GTA. I didn't play GTA 1 or 2. But up to this point, I've loved all the Grand Theft Auto games. So, here's my opinion on the GTA 6 trailer. I think the game looks amazing, but it doesn't look as interesting as I was hoping. Maybe because of the trailer. I don't think they made a really good trailer for this game. There's a lot of things that I don't really care about that they're showing. Like, I love that they're showing a different variety of NPCs, a different variety of vehicles. They're showing the graphics, the beautiful water, the beautiful landscape of Miami, right? Vice City. I love that. But there are certain things that don't need to be in this video, which I understand it's a Grand Theft Auto game and it exists in the GTA universe. But a lot of those crazy clips of crazy NPCs doing random shit, I just personally don't care for it. I think it was such a boring thing to watch during the trailer. Like, I want to see more of the story. I want to see, I want to see what gunfights are like, what the explosions look like. I want to see car chases. You know, I think that's what most people want to see. In this trailer, I understand it's just a little snippet of what's possible in the GTA world. I understand it, but it was kind of a boring trailer and it was underwhelming to me. I didn't really see much to digest. Like, I wasn't too excited when I was watching it, even though deep down I knew that, hey, this game's going to be amazing because every GTA so far has been amazing. So I have high hopes for this and I do believe in it. But I don't know, the trailer just didn't hype me up as much as it did for everyone else. So let's talk about the screenshots here. And while you guys are looking at this, you guys are obviously seeing some GTA 5 modded gameplay. So this here is the first screenshot we're looking at here. This is the opening scene for the trailer here. Now, there's not much to see here. Some things that kind of caught my eye, which I didn't really understand in a lot of these photos, actually. There are certain little things here and there. This one in particular has a very strange tower. I mean, holy crap, that is the tallest radio tower I have ever seen. And weird how a plane is flying extremely close to it. But anyways, just little weird things I spotted in trailers. These are not game breaking, or they're not gonna like, oh, make me not buy the game. No, these are just little things I noticed that were kind of weird. And I will point out some Easter eggs to you guys as well, because I caught, I think, one or two. I can't really remember. But yeah, so we got, you know, this trailer here that breaks down certain part of Vice City. We got a prison here. Really, that's all I noticed there. So the prison, the radio tower, and the plane flying too close to it. Then we have what looks to be duplicate assets here. I'm not too sure what's up with that. You know, maybe it's just from distance. I'm not too sure, but that looks a little weird. And these are things, oddly enough, my brain, these are the things that I just spotted. But yeah, so that's it for the first first little image here. I drew over the actual picture, but yeah, it's I mean, it looks good. You know, this shot looked good for sure. So in this shot here, we get our first introduction to Lucia. Now, in the photo itself, we do, I guess, get some information on her family members. I'm not too sure if this is a photo from her family. I'm not 100% on that. If it's not, it's not. It is what it is. But we do get our first look at the main character. Now, I heard, at least there were rumors going around, that you will be able to play as her boyfriend as well. I don't know his name, but I think you can play as two characters. Now, again, these are rumors. I don't know if they're true, and I'm not stating that they're true. But if it is true, that would be awesome as well. Definitely, a lot of people, by the way, have huge issues with a female playable character in GTA. I don't understand it, personally. Like, I don't see the hate for it. I think it's cool. It's a cool character. I mean, I don't see anything that's like, you know, I don't think anything is pushing it too far there, but, you know, it is what it is. Moving on to the next image here. This image is pretty cool and very important, actually. If you guys played Vice City, you guys know where this beach is. You guys kind of recognize certain parts of this screenshot here. Now, I can't really show it on screen because I don't have GTA Vice City installed, but this here, this area right here with this building looks very familiar. So, I don't know, maybe it's just me, but I know Tommy used to live somewhere around here. And if you drove down this way, you would spot like a secret vehicle here. It was like a dune buggy right next to this big building. That's what it looks like to me. Now, of course, this map will be completely changed, but it kind of just looks like it to me. I'm not saying it's an Easter egg, obviously, because it most likely is a replica of Miami. Just like how they replicated California in GTAV, they're going to do the same thing. So yeah, we have that. Now the city here in the background is, it looks massive. We see massive skyscrapers and man, this map is gonna be just huge. One thing I also love is the beach. Look at how much activity is going on. One thing about GTA 5, it wasn't too, it was good. Like the NPCs were good, everything felt alive, but I always felt like there wasn't too much of traffic or too much NPCs as there should have been in California. But in this trailer here, we're seeing a lot of NPCs. Now, I don't know if it's just in the trailer and maybe in the full release it's nothing like this, but it kind of looks like we're getting a lot of NPCs and the game will feel more alive. Like the whole world will be alive, which is great. I love that. I love the feeling of games like that. So definitely excited for that. Glad to see a full beach. Now, one thing I've been doing this whole time is just drawing over these photos and not even creating a new layer, but it is what it is. So here we get a snippet of some pretty hectic things here. We got a, I forgot what they call this. I'm a car guy, okay? But, oh yeah, I think these are called rollers. So this guy's capturing a roller, and then there's this crazy lady who's who thinks she's invincible out of this convertible here. Young people, you know, they always think they're invincible. But anyways, so we have a brand new vehicle here, which looks incredible. Now, it looks like a Ferrari to me, a mix of a Ferrari and a mix of an e-car. But we do see this thing pop, and we do see this thing shoot some flames. So it's definitely not an e-car. I'm not too sure what we're looking at, but damn, this thing looks beautiful, and I can't wait to own one of these in GTA. And then, of course, the red car as well. I think it's brand new. I don't think it's the same car. Definitely not the same car. But yeah, we got obviously new cars in GTA. I'm not too sure if these are carryovers from GTA 5's latest updates or if they're absolutely brand new. I know a lot of them are carryovers though, and we'll point that out later on. But of course, we see a bunch of sports cars here, so it's looking good for the sports car world. I think this game is heavily focused on cars and car customization, just like GTA V was. So I'm very excited for that. Now, we don't see much in this photo other than nightlife, highway, and cars. Pretty cool, but nothing too crazy. So let's move on to the next one. Here we see something pretty interesting as well. So this here, if you guys played Vice City, this looks like those little islands that split apart the main islands in the game. So in Vice City, you have two mini islands in the middle of the map. One is, I believe, dead center in the middle. The other one's like on top more. And then, oh no, we have three. I think we have three little islands. I don't know. I can't remember. But I know we have two big main islands that we have to go to. And one of them is not unlocked until you progress through the missions. Now, this here looks like the area that Tommy used to live in. Specifically speaking, I want to say, I'm not too sure which side of the map this would be on. But for me, I would say this side would have been where Tommy used to live in the mansion. Now again, this is a whole redesign, so no, it's not actually where he lived, but it just looks like it. And yeah, this is a cool screenshot, man. We see like some, I think, border action here, and not really border, but you know, it's like a ticket dispenser crossing over to the next island or whatever. I don't know, like gates to the next island. So let's erase that. So yeah, it's pretty cool. We see a lot of aircrafts and boats and stuff like that. Like, we see a ton of boats over here. We see a bunch of aircrafts in almost every single... Oh, that's not an aircraft. We see it in almost every single shot when they're, you know, going over the ocean or, you know, through the sky. Like, we see a lot here. We even see a yacht. And I'm not sure if that's drivable, but it looks like it's drivable. So that's pretty cool. So moving on to the next one here. All right, nightlife. This is where the first Easter egg shows up. Now, you guys may not know it, and that's fine, but I'm going to explain it to you guys, and I'm going to explain what the Easter egg is. Not only that, I'm going to be talking a little bit about the cars here, because we have some real-life replicas, of course. Most of this stuff is a carryover from GTA 5's DLCs, for sure, because I can already tell. But that's awesome anyways. At least a lot of people who never got to experience it get to experience it this time. So, let's get on with the Easter egg here. Right off the bat here, we are seeing Tommy Vercetti's home. Like, this was his home in Vice City. If you guys remember, I can't remember the hotel's name, but I'm pretty damn sure that this right here was where he lived. Not only that, but we see the Oceanic over here. I don't know if it's the Oceanic, but it's the same color. It's literally the same color, and it looks like a classic car, just like the Oceanic. So I'm just going to assume that that is exactly what it is. So that's a pretty, I think that's our first Easter egg, and I could be wrong, but who knows? Like, correct me on it, you know, just let me know in the comment section below. Other things we see the new sports car right here. I highlighted that wrong. Okay, I literally did the same thing. Anyway, we see the new sports car here that we saw on the highway. We see a Corvette C8. Now, I think in the game it's going to be called, like, Coquette. So we're going to be seeing that here. Of course, we got a motorcycle here, which I just completely ignored. I forgot what this car is called right here, but I'm not really too interested. We got the classic Cheetah back in the game, which is like a classic Ferrari. We've got a Porsche 911 Turbo here, unless it's like a Carrera GT. I can't remember. No, it's not a Carrera GT. What am I talking about? That's a whole different car. I'm a car guy, but I can't remember the Porsches, man. They kind of all look the same to me nowadays. And then here we have a some sort of a Lamborghini Aventador replica. We got a Challenger right here. So yeah, we've got a bunch of cool cars coming back into the game, which is awesome. Other than that, we don't really see much happening in this trailer. I was hoping that this here would be an Easter egg, but I'm not too sure. And this building looks accessible, but I don't think it will be. I think it's just there as like a, you know, it's just there for show. Next screenshot here, we see an overview of the beautiful blue ocean. It looks fantastic. I think this part of the game is going to be, honestly, this GTA will be the nicest GTA we've had so far in terms of quality. Yeah, this looks great. So we have a lot of, well, looks to be 2D vehicles here. Cyberpunk. No, I'm joking. No, this looks great though. We have a plane flying by. We have yachts again. A bunch of boats, cargo ships. So like, I don't know if these are interactable or not, but they are everywhere in the trailer. So maybe this is a good sign. Maybe there's going to be more endless gameplay with these types of things in the game. So pretty cool. But again, nothing happening here. This is a real life thing. This here is the most hated thing by the car community. And I am included in that. I hate this stuff. I'm glad they put it in the game. In the game, sure, I don't care. It's a game. But in real life, this is called a takeover. And the car scene absolutely hates this stuff. because real car people don't do this. This is illegal and this is not cool. So in real life, I absolutely dread it. But in the game, I am glad they're adding in things that are in real life. So that is pretty damn cool. Now we have a bunch of cars here that I cannot name for the life of me. But if I had to take a guess here, oops, this here is probably a Saline Mustang or some sort of a Shelby, like replica, of course. Looks really cool. This here looks like a BMW M2 of some sort. Again, very, very cool. I'm glad they add cars like that. I can't tell what those cars are. I'm hoping that we get a BRZ replica. We'll see. So yeah, we have a lot of cool cars, man. I'm very, very happy with the car selections here. The weird thing is, I don't see much bonafide vehicles, but we do see a lot of vehicles in general, so that's good. Unless these are modified, they look slightly modded, I don't know. This one looks like an R34, but definitely not. So we'll see. This here is our next little screenshot. This one here, I'm a gun nut as well as a car guy, so, you know, of course, right off the bat, I'm noticing the firearms. And I'm happy to say that they're bringing in more real replicas than the last game. The last game had some good firearms, but this game looks even better. The M4A1 carbine, which this dude is holding right here. We've got some sort of a Kimber 1911 in his hand, and then of course the same thing in his hand. So it's pretty damn cool. Not only that, but we get first person gameplay with a body cam. Now I'm not too sure if you can play like this. I'm hoping you can, but I doubt it. This looks awesome anyways, and we have a house raid. Not only that, but they have a dog in the house, so I'm not too sure if that's going to be interactable in-game. I did see pets during the trailer, so hopefully we'll get some interaction with animals as well. Here we have a pretty crazy scene, but I want to point it out a little bit here. So we've got monster trucks coming back. We've got, there's, behind this guy, I didn't take a really good screenshot of the vehicle behind him. But right here, where I'm circling, there is some sort of a cool-looking like dune buggy with... it doesn't actually have a body of a vehicle. It's just wheels and like a basket on top at the bottom. Or sorry, like a trunk bed. I don't know what they call it, man. But it looks really cool, so I'm definitely excited for that. Not much to see in this screenshot. Again, this trailer just, to me, didn't really show much. It just mainly showed how crazy people are in the GTA universe, and it showed off some vehicles. That's really all I could see here. Next screenshot here is, again, more vehicles. We do see the new character here. I didn't take the screenshot to see him. I actually just wanted to take the screenshot for the vehicles once again, but we do see the new character here for the first time in the trailer, and he looks to be pretty cool. Again, I hope we can play as him as well as his girlfriend, Lucia. We'll see how that works out. But here we finally have a damn proper Ford Crown Victoria replica. Shit, man, it took a long time for GTA to do this. I don't even think GTA 5 had something that looked similar to this. I know GTA 4 had it, kind of, but that's not what I'm looking for. This here is what I'm looking for, so I'm glad to see that being back. Or sorry, I'm glad to see that being added. And here we have one of those typical Ford SUV police cars as well that we see in real life. Pretty cool that they're finally doing all these things. Now, I'm not too sure if this is meant to be an Easter egg or not, but it cures emotions. I'm assuming they're referring to not only the actual in-game brand of pills or whatever, and you know, GTA always has this great sense of humor, but I think it's also referring to the GTA trailer being released, right? It cures emotions because we finally get a GTA trailer and a new GTA game. But yeah, there's that. And we do have working dials in the car, which means first person should be returning. Moving on to the next screenshot here. Again, more car stuff. We have more modern police cars. We have a lot of variety of police cars. So far, we have caught four different types of police vehicles. So pay attention to that because it's kind of cool. We have our typical modern day police cars here. We have Dodge Challenger police cars, or again, replicas. We have a Porsche, you know, classic 911. So this is pretty damn cool. I'm very excited for that. We have, you know, typical Challenger. I hate these cars, honestly. No matter what GTA they're in, I don't like them. They're annoying. I kind of wish they just changed the models for him. Banshee, definitely a good little spot there. The Banshee has been the same since GTA 4, so definitely cool to see back again. And then we have some other cool little cars here. But yeah, We also spot bicycles, so bicycles are coming back. We have, obviously, motorcycles. We have whatever that is. I think it's an ATV. And yeah, there we go. Just people going crazy again in the trailer, as usual. Another scene here. Again, we get a beautiful screenshot of another police vehicle. I'm going to do a proper highlight here because that bothers me so much. Oh, now the lines are not connecting. Anyways, so yeah, we have a cool vehicle here. You know, police Dodge Charger, basically. So awesome to see that. Now, I don't know if this is a cutscene in a mission, but if it's not, then this would also be a very cool effect when you crash your car. Radiators spilling out and, you know, this stuff actually spilling onto the road and staining it for a little while. Then we have what looks to be oil spills. I don't think it is. I think it's a shadow, but anyways. So yeah, I think this looks pretty cool. It's like a wreckage, obviously, and looks cool. I mean, hopefully the damage models are great in this game, just like they were in GTA 4 and 5. But we'll just have to see. We get a snippet here of two of the main characters in the game robbing what looks to be a liquor store. So here is where I'm going to talk about the story, okay? Because this is what I'm worried about. Are we getting the same story as GTA 5? Because all I've seen in this trailer was money and robbing stores. Like, I'll be honest with you guys, I'm hoping it's not going to be this, because GTA 5 did it. They pulled it off well. I like the story to it. It is what it is. And there was obviously a deeper meaning to that story as well. But if they're going to do the same thing again, I'm going to be quite disappointed. So I'm hoping that there's more to this and not just robbing stores and banks. I'm hoping that we get to do other things as well. Maybe this will be like a side mission to get some money, but the main story would be something completely different. That's what I'm hoping for. And I'm sure, you know, Rockstar Games being as one of the greater AAA game companies, I'm sure they're going to make something fantastic out of this. But again, I'm just hoping that it will be fantastic and it will be different. So here we have another snippet of another cool car. This was after their little liquor store robbery, I assume. And we got what looks to be a Chevelle SS. This is a pretty classic muscle car and it's badass. And it looks really good. Now we have some different character positions while they're passenger or while you're driving, whatever. You know, we have her sticking her hand out, holding on to the glass panel here. Not too sure if every character is going to do that when you take a hard turn or whatever. But if they add cool details like that, I will appreciate it. I'm also excited about one thing here, which is tire smoke. I know this is like pathetically small. Oops, that looks terrible. Pathetically small, but as someone who likes to drift in GTA and drift in general in games, again, being a car guy, I love drifting. You could see the tire smoke from pretty damn far away. It doesn't seem to disappear very quickly. So I'm hoping that this is not just a cutscene, and I'm hoping that it's also in the official game. And of course, here we see what looks to be one of those G-Wagons. I don't know what they call it in GTA. And we have a new SUV here, which looks like an Audi, like S6 or something, or not S6, like Q6, that's what I meant to say, Q7 or whatever they call it. Pretty cool. And then we have some more classical-ish trucks, you know, some older models, which looks pretty cool as well. But yeah, everything here just looks fantastic. The detail, everything. Like, look at the road, man. Like, this here is, these are a pretty big deal. I know it's small, but it's a big deal because when you're driving around and you see these things, it just makes the world look more alive. And I think, again, that is something that I love in GTA. So this here is actually the last screenshot that we took. So that's basically it for today's video. After this, it was just a screenshot of them breaking into a liquor store. So I didn't really want to take a photo of that. But she was holding some sort of a Glock, which I noticed, or Glock model. And but yeah, that's basically it. So definitely, I'm excited for the game again, but I'm not like super overly hyped. That's basically it for today's video. Yeah, man, like, you know, conclusion. I feel good about this game. I think it's going to be great. It's going to be another success, hopefully, especially since, you know, GTA, we only get it like once every 10 years, man. Like, it's crazy. And even now, we have to wait till 2025 to play this. That is just, that's just wild. But anyway, that is what it is. Hopefully, they don't delay it, and hopefully, it is a true masterpiece of a game. We'll see, man. We'll see. But, yeah, game looks good. I like it. Trailer wasn't too exciting, hoping for something better. I didn't mention a couple things like wildlife, which I noticed there was a lot of wildlife, crocodiles, or alligators, whatever. Seagulls, you know, flamingos, sharks, dolphins. I seen all of that. I just didn't want to point it out. I guess it was in the last GTA as well. But yeah, we have everything coming back plus more. So I'm excited, man. We'll see what happens with this game. Anyways, hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you guys did, hit that like button, guys. Subscribe if you're new to the channel. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Peace out, everyone. Hope you enjoyed.